Welcome in, everyone. Today I'm going to demonstrate how to make some of our tickets just on our own. It's very simple. I saw the video on YouTube. Unfortunately, I can't remember who it was that was demonstrating it, but it's really a simple process, and so I'm not claiming it for myself, but I just wanted to show you because I think it's really interesting that you can just use your own stamps and punch them, you know, just as tickets, and then just cut them. So this is what the outcome looks like. And so now I'm going to show you the process. So basically it's just taking stamps that, and I don't think it really matters. I just chose thin stamps that I thought would work on these tickets. But, you know, when you cut the tickets to the size that you want, if it overlaps, it doesn't really matter because they kind of do that anyway. And I think it gives it a little interest. But let me just start by stamping. And I'll use the stamp a few times just to ease the process a little bit. I hope I'm in camera here. So I hope everyone's having a great day. This is early in the morning for me, but lots of errands to run today, so I thought I would come on and do this before I get out on the road. And stamping is not one of my fortes, I must say, but I don't really think it matters for this process. Now, if you're making a card, I'd defer to someone else to do the stamping. Like I said, you can use any stamps that you have. These are just Tim Holtz stamps that I happen to really like, the vintage style. And of course, you know, you can just do it off the side. When you cut it, it won't matter. It'll still look great. So tip that, fit that. We don't have room for this. Put this number here. Here, and maybe here. Then I have one more skinny stamp to try and fill in this little edge. But like I said, you know, you could use script. You could use, I don't know, so many background stamps I'm sure you have. And then just cut it, which I will show you shortly. And I hope I can do one right here. Should I hit something to go there, but really have anything skinny, so that's just gonna be if I stick this there. You don't have to cover the whole thing, obviously. It's just me being me. So now that you've stamped everything, take your hole punch. Now this at the end, I'm just going to do a half punch. Now this is a really tiny hole punch. Ideally, I wish I had the other one, so I'm going to look into getting one of the bigger sizes because I think it actually would look better. But at least you can see what I'm doing. Okay. This is why I don't like this hole punch, because it doesn't punch very well. Definitely need to invest in a different one. I am not punching the entire hole. I'm doing half the hole, which if you look at a regular ticket, that's kind of what they look like. So on those corners is where my stand hands, but that's how they would look if you were to buy them. I can even trim this with scissors if I need to. And then do the end. But I also need to do this corner, which isn't really working for me right now. So now, of course, you can use a paper trimmer to do this, but I had already folded the paper, so I think it'll be easy for me to trim on a straight line here. And now you punch in the middle, right across from where you punched the other hole or half hole, and then do another half hole on this side. Same thing again. I'm more concerned with lining it up with this hole than this hole. I mean, yes, you want to try and line it up, but when you're cutting straight across, that's the one I want to make sure it matches. And ideally, when you have the bigger hole punch, it'll punch better. So you won't have these kind of issues that I'm having, but I'm going to trim it with my scissors anyways. It'll just be like a little guide. And as always, if you turn your punch upside down, you can see where you're punching the hole. If you punch this way, you can't really tell where you're punching the hole. So it's just a little trick, I'm sure you already know, but passing that on. I always use my punches upside down. So still on camera, I hope. I'm trying to get better at filming these so you aren't missing things that I'm doing off screen here. Mission today when I'm running errands is to get a hole punch, a regular hole punch. Then you just take your scissors and cut straight across. Unfortunately, the holes aren't really big because this is a small punch. So I'm going to trim one a little bit for you so you can see. It's a little better. Which you could do this with scissors too. Just cut them and then use your scissors just to make the little indentions. But have a good hole punch, it goes much faster. That one was a little short. I'd rather them be longer. Let's try this one. Obviously, you can make these any size you want, skinny, longer. All that matters is how you cut the paper after you trim it. I mean, after you stamp it. So, I have some tickets that are like really skinny and long. I have these short little wider ones. So you can make these any size you want. And you could even print these out on your computer and say you were making a book for someone. Put their name all over the ticket. Make them personalized for whatever book you're making. For instance, if it's an Easter journal, put a bunch of Easter language on the tickets. Or a garden journal, put names of herbs and flowers on them. I mean, if you're going to print them, you can do anything you want. But I just happen to use these stamps. So then anyway, at this point, they're done. You can distress them around the edges, which will make those cuts stand out a little bit more. But now you have your own tickets. You can customize them any way you want using stamps that you have or images that you want to print from online. It's really something easy to do and kind of fun. I mean, you know, if you just stamp a bunch of paper at night when you're watching TV, then you just punch all the holes and cut them. And then you have a whole slew of tickets ready to go in your journals. So you have stockpile. And these could be traded on our Mondays Extra Extra. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I would love to hear your comments or your ideas of using these or how to make them differently, what you would use them for, and just keep crafting along and sharing your ideas with everybody. I think it's a great idea to inspire everyone. Like, you could even make it this long if you wanted to. Don't cut it here. Just do them this big. However you want. Make them thinner. Sky's the limit on what you can do with these. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. And just come back soon. And I will be listing more videos very soon. So, please subscribe to the channel and like these videos and help to keep them at the top of the feed so others are aware of them. And let's just share our ideas and inspire one another. So have a great day, and I will see you again really soon.